In this video, I'll be talking about the British Pattern 1888 bayonet, from the Mark I to the Pattern 1903, and how to identify the various differences between the marks. The first of the 1888 type bayonets is the Mark I. Approved on the 20th of June 1889, and the production ran to 25,000, mainly produced at Enfield. There might be a couple of stragglers out there by Wilkinson's, but it was discontinued due to the two small rivets did not secure the grips very well after they had been trimmed down in production. Most of the Mark I first types found are in poor condition and are rare to the market. As you can see, it's a different fitment to the bayonet below, which was for the Martini Henry. And this pattern 1888 was fitted to the Mark I Lee Metford rifle. Right here, the bayonet has been fitted to the Mark I Lee Metford in the underbarrel position. On the ricasso, you can see the date of October 1889 and the VR cipher. And on the reverse is a WD acceptance stamp with the Enfield inspector's mark. Right, the next bayonet is the Mark I second type. It was suggested by Wilkinson's and accepted in December 1889 that they should use two large rivets instead of the two small ones on the Mark I first type. It was approved on the 25th of February 1890 and the production was over 500,000. They're the more common Mark I bayonet, a Mark I second type. The next bayonet in the series is the Pattern 1888 Mark II. With the advent of the clearing rod being removed from new Enfield rifles and a pull-through used, it enabled the rivets to be placed further apart on the handle of the bayonet and the clearance hole to be moved closer to the catch in the pommel. So this is the Mark II bayonet. Over 236,000 were produced at Enfield, and the approval date for the removal of the clearing rod was August 1899. So Mark II bayonets should be dated after that date. This is the Mark II Pattern 1888 bayonet. The next bayonet in the series is the Mark III. It was approved in September 1901, and the difference between this and the Mark II is that it's got screws going through the grips on the bayonet itself with nuts on the reverse side, which enabled the woodwork to be replaced if damaged. So this is the Mark III Pattern 1888 bayonet for the Longley Enfield. The last in this series is the rarer Pattern 1903 bayonet. With the advent of the introduction of the SMLE rifle, the pommel fixing has changed. The list of changes were announced in December 1902 in the list of changes, paragraph 11716, dated the 19th of December. Approximate production was 119,000 at Enfield, and the scabbard is the Mark I land pattern scabbard, which is basically common to most of the bayonets in this collection. I hope you found this short video on the Pattern 1888 bayonet useful, and happy collecting.